Hello, my name is Adriana. I'm a Make More Librarian with LA County Library. And we are spotlighting African-American pioneers in the field of STEAM. Today, we're going to highlight Bessie Blount Griffin, a person of many skills and talents. She was a physical therapist, a businesswoman, a forensic analyst, an inventor. I know, what an inspiration. She did so much. And by the end of this video, I'll be showing you some of our resources so you can become the next big inventor if you feel inspired. On November 24th, 1914, Bessie Blount was born in a rural town of Hickory, Virginia. This was during a time when racism was prevalent, but even with all the challenges she faced, she was innovative, inspiring, and kept pushing the limit, not only for herself, but for others. A beacon of strength and perseverance. At the age of 6, she had a life-altering experience that changed her direction in life. Her elementary school teacher struck her hands for using her left hand to write, which angered her. But this also led her to become ambidextrous, the ability to write with her left and right. In addition, she taught herself to write with her mouth and toes. Later on, she would use this skill to help others. Bessie Blount faced many challenges, including dropping out of school in the 6th grade. Years later, she went back and obtained her GED, attended college to become a nurse, received her license as a physical therapist, worked at various hospitals, including the Bronx Hospital. During this time, her focus was on rehabilitating patients who were paralyzed or amputated and lost the use of their arms to perform daily tasks like feeding themselves. Many of her patients were World War II veterans. She went as far as teaching them on her own time in her own home to write with their feet and mouth. Little by little, their self-esteem and independence improved. She was always eager to help others and was inspired to invent a device where they could feed themselves independently. The device required the user to bite down on the tube where the food would come down from a food container. This allowed the user to control the amount of food without any help. With her invention success, her plan was to offer it to the U.S. Veterans Administration. However, they were not interested. She even took her invention to a television show called The Big Idea in 1953, becoming the first woman and African-American woman to appear on the show. Unfortunately, still no interest stateside, but the French government were very fascinated, and eventually, Bessie licensed it freely to the French government. When asked why she would donate her invention freely, she responded with, "A colored woman is capable of inventing something for the benefit of mankind," showing that her accomplishments were not driven by fame or fortune. Bessie Blount continued to dedicate her time on assistive devices and invented a disposable basin out of a baked mixture of newspaper, flour, and water. Still, once again, there was no interest from the U.S. Veterans Administration. She would eventually sell her invention to the Belgium government, and to this day, they use a modified version of her invention. As an African-American woman, she encountered various obstacles, including finding support for her invention, but that did not stop her. She continued to be an ally for those who needed it. And here is a patent that was issued to Bessie Blount in 1951. And this is a portable receptacle support, and this was designed for people who were injured or ill, so that way they could hold a bowl or a cup close to their face. By 1962, Bessie Blount Griffin stepped back from nursing and began a new career using her skills for analyzing handwriting for the police department of Vineland, Norfolk, and Portsmouth as a forensic scientist. She specialized in forgeries. By 1972, she became the chief document examiner. She then set her eyes on the FBI, but because of her race, she was rejected. But that did not stop her. In fact, when she was 63, she left to the United Kingdom to advance her skills in analyzing documents with Scotland Yard, the London Metro Police. Even after she retired as a forensic analyst, she started her own business and used the skills she acquired to analyze and examine documents from the Civil War era, like slave papers. She continued to help others until she passed away at the age of 95 on December 30th, 2009. Bessie Blount Griffin was an innovator and an inspiration, but not much is written about her. But fortunately, I was able to learn about her from a book called Wonder Women, 25 Innovators, Inventors, and Trailblazers Who Changed History by Sam Maggs. There may not be much written about her, but because of her, many were able to gain their independence to write or even feed themselves. And with the help of LA County Library and their database for magazines and newspapers, I found an article from the October 1947 issue of Ebony Magazine highlighting her accomplishments with amputee veterans. And here in this article, you'll find images of Bessie Blount Griffin not only writing with her mouth, but teaching others how to write with their mouth or drink out of cup. A fun fact I learned in this article is that she was learning to type with her toes. She's unstoppable. I hope you enjoyed learning about Bessie as much as I did. But please visit our website if you feel inspired to create an invention of your own. Click on the link on how to get started using one of our at-home activity sheets for adults, Becoming an Inventor, as recommendations for books and magazines, including online courses with Linda, and it's all free with our library card. Thank you for watching this video. Please click on the link in the description box for up and coming programs. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for new videos. Thank you and bye everyone.